Welcome to yoga class number 6. Every day is another chance to get stronger, to eat better, to live healthier, and to be the best version of you. Gomukhasana, or the cow face pose, strengthens the hip joints and provides power to your ankles and thighs. When the hands are in asana, it provides power to your shoulders and arms as well. The asana helps strengthen your spine and abdominal muscles. Sit up tall and stack your knees directly on top of each other. Be sure to keep the back straight and relaxed. Now close your eyes and focus on your breath for half a minute. Now slowly rub your hands and cup your eyes with the warmth of your palm. Now lower your hands and let's get ready for warm up. Now let's have some fun with the teddy bear challenge number 1. Today we will perform 5 of the challenges: jumping with both feet, hopping on the right foot, hopping on the left foot, scorpion walk, and duck walk. And of course, pick up your toys once you're done. And now let's quickly look at the fitness attitude for this week. Let this week's focus be on the food we eat. A healthy outside starts from the inside. We need to nourish our body with healthy food to perform its best. Let's perform this week's stretches with a prop. So quickly grab your football or basketball or even just a balloon. Hands parallel. Stretch out your hands in front and let's exercise those wrists up and down. One more time. Up and down. Now let's move to the neck. Hold the ball in front. Turn to your right, chin over the right shoulder. Turn to your left, chin over the left shoulder. One more time, chin over the right shoulder and chin over the left shoulder. Now let's club the shoulders and the upward stretch. Stretch out the ball over your head Bring it back to the chest. One more time. Stretch the ball out over your head. Back to the chest. Now stretch downward. Stretch the hands. Bring it back to your chest. Stretch downwards. And bring the ball back to your chest. Now to the side. Stretch for the trunk. Stretch to the right side. Stretch to the left side. Once again, stretch your trunk to the right and last to the left. Now let's go back. Let's do the back stretch. Stretch and arch back. Stretch and arch forward with a tabletop back. One more time. Stretch and arch back. And stretch forward with a tabletop back. Now let's twist the trunk. Stretch to the right. Once you feel the stretch, slowly stretch to the left. One more time. Stretch fully to the right. And stretch to the left. Now for the hips and knees, lunge forward, right leg forward. Go back, take the right foot back. One more time. Lunge forward with the right leg in front and slowly take the right leg back. Let's do this for the left leg. Lunge forward with the left leg. Take the left leg back. One more time. Lunge forward, strengthening the knees and hips together. And take the left leg back. Now for the last joint to be stretched, the ankles. Place the ball down. Point the toes down, ankles up. Point the toes up and feel the stretch in the ankle. One more time. Toes pointed down. Roll the ball, toes pointed up. Now let's stretch the left ankle, toes pointed up, toes pointed down. One more time, stretch the toes up and stretch the toes down. Now let's get ready for asana. Now let's run a quick recap on the standing asanas that we should be doing every day, starting with Garudasana or the one leg balance. Garudasana, knees together and bent, right elbow over left elbow. Entwine the arms to touch the palms. Entwine the knees and the ankles. Relax. Take the left elbow over the right elbow. Entwine the arms. Take the right knee over the left knee. Try to interlock the ankles. Let's repeat this one more time. Right elbow over the left elbow. Entwine the arms and touch the palms. Left knee over the right knee. Interlock the ankles and relax. Left elbow over the right elbow. Entwine the arms to touch the palms. Right knee over the left knee, interlock the ankles and release. Pavan Muktasana side variation today. Take the knees to the right side of the body, interlock the hands behind. Raise the left knee, take it to the side of the body, interlock the hands from behind. Let's repeat this once again. Take the knee to the right side of the body and interlock the hands behind. Left knee to the side of the body, interlock the hands from behind. Now let's do Talasana 1, 1 foot distance. Raise the right hand, stretch it up on your toes, turn the palms, backward rotation, bring the hands down. Left hand stretched out, stretched up. Turn the palms, backward rotation, hands in, heels down together. One more time, hands stretched up, turn the palm, bring the hands down. Left hand up, stretched, turn, backward rotation, heels and hands down together. Pranayamasan, the first step of Surya Namaskar. Hasta Uttanasan, hands parallel, arched back. Hastapadasan, hands parallel, forehead to knees. One more time, Hasta Uttanasan, Hastapadasan. Arch back, rotate the palms, rotate the hands, come back to Pranayamasan. And now once more to the soundtrack. Try everything and discover your own possibilities.
Nobody will learn without getting it wrong.
Now let us learn how to do Konasana or the angle pose for sideward stretching of the spine. This stretch significantly contributes to the health of the internal organs. As the starting position, keep the feet wide apart, parallel, and hands at the sides of the body. Keep your eyes focused on a point in front of you. Now stretch out the right hand and take it to close to the head. Keep the hips and legs unmoving. Only curve the spine. Come back to center. Rotate the palms and slowly bring the right hand down. Repeat with the left hand. Take the left hand close to the head. Not moving the hips and the legs, only curve the spine, the neck and the head to a right angle with the base. Slowly come up, turn the palms, stretching out your hands, bring the hands down.